Welcome to meditation number 4. Today, I want you to grab something from around your home or wherever you are, and something small, and bring it into your meditation space with you. This could be maybe a small plant or a crystal or a book, a letter from someone, just something dear to you. It does not have to be anything specific, just whatever first comes to mind that you hold dear to your heart. Go ahead and take a moment to pause the video, grab that little item. If you're outside in the forest or in nature, maybe pick something up that has already fallen onto the floor and hold that with you, such as a flower or pine needles or a leaf or a rock, you know, whatever is non-damaging to the earth around us that you feel a connection to. And when you're ready, go ahead and begin the video again after getting comfortable and ready to begin. Welcome back. Go ahead and whether you're sitting or standing, place this item where you feel called to place it. Maybe that's at your heart center, maybe that's above your head, resting at your crown, maybe at your root chakra, maybe at your feet. There is no right place for this item. Just place it where you feel called to. And then get back in your comfortable resting position. Close your eyes. And let's begin by taking a few breaths, inhaling through the mouth, through the nose. And exhaling deeply through the mouth. Audible exhale. Let's go ahead and do this a few more times as we let go of the stresses of the week, the day, the month, the year. We are here to rest, relax, rejuvenate. Good. Breathing, releasing. And when you feel ready, I want you to allow your breath to become normalized. So we are going to focus more on regulating our heartbeat and our breath to the natural beat and hum of the earth instead of having a deep intention behind that breath. So if you still need a few moments to figure out where that space is for you, or you've really got some pent-up energy you need to let go of, that is totally fine. Please take your time. And when you're ready, you are going to gently sink deeper into that space of just sinking into the earth. So from here, as we allow our breath to normalize, become soft, we allow our heartbeat to soften. Let our eyelids soften so we're not scrunching them up. Maybe letting our teeth separate slightly as we pull our tongue away from the roof of our mouth. Our shoulders sink down closer to the earth. Our muscles fall away from the bones as we sink deeper into a relaxing, loving hold that the soil and the earth and the core of our planet has on us. Allow her to take you into her arms. Allow yourself to feel comforted by Mother Earth. Feel yourself shaking off all of that pent-up chaotic energy and just resting into a space of regeneration. From here, I want you to bring your peripheral antennae, so to speak, to notice the energy of your chosen item. So we're keeping our eyes closed, and while we are aware of the spatial location of this item, I want you to, instead of focusing on that and picturing it in your visual mind, I want you to allow its energy to touch you. Allow its vibration to create a space for itself that meshes with your own, one that you can notice and respect. So while you are calling in the energy of this being to mesh with yours, you are also saying, I respect your space. I respect your need to vibrate as an individual and as a collective of one. If you're having trouble feeling that energy, then I want you to picture the item and what feelings it invokes within you. Maybe memories or a person who's dear to you that gifted you this item. Whatever connection you have to this thing, allow those feelings to draw the vibration of this thing, this living thing, even if this is a rock or a gem or a book, it's still a living thing, still has a soul. Breathe into their vibration. Breathe into the gratitude of sharing space with this being. And so much gratitude for their sharing of love, existence, and healing vibrations. Because really, we have called this item in to help us heal in one way or another. We have felt called to this item in particular, this being, for a reason. Maybe it's not clear right in this moment, and you're still allowing those building vibrations to reach you, but it will become clear now or later. And practicing with our intuition this way, by allowing an item or a being to call to us instead of searching, well, that's a much bigger act. Because when we practice little forms of manifestation and connection and listening like this, we're creating space in our lives to do this in a much bigger way. We are reaffirming that we know how to do this, and that we feel connected to all these beautiful little pieces of our life, that we respect the web of oneness. And while something so small as choosing something around us to accompany us during a meditation, it really is creating and representing that we have not lost the ability to listen, to intuit our needs for healing, our needs for growth, our needs for self-love. And it also reminds us to create a sense of equality with the things around us. And equality resonates with respect. Rocks, items around the house, things that seemingly are just there become so much more when we have this profound respect for everything around us. We're willing to kill a fly, but not a beautiful butterfly. Where's the fairness in that? Where's the respect in that? And if we start showing that respect by presenting gratitude to these items, these living things, and calling them beings, we start to more deeply understand how these little, seemingly insignificant beings play such a major role in our lives, in our abilities to be compassionate, in our ability to see others as they are, without putting our mask on them so they fit in our lives just the way that we want them to. We're saying, I see you. A plant may sit above your head and you think, I guess I've seen you in my home. I've seen you grow. I've seen you turn brown and green, and I've seen you shine in the sun. But have I really seen you? Have I given you gratitude for the joy you bring me? Have I given you gratitude for purifying the air in my home? Have I appreciated the growth I've seen you undergo? And the transformations when you're not feeling well and you need more water? When we start to notice, just notice these things a little deeper, we invoke a childlike wonder that so many of us, at least partially, lost long, long ago. And we start to realize that's why kids have so much fun. They look around in awe and gratitude of the beauty, the inspiration, the incredible knowledge that is held within these seemingly whatever items around us, beings around us. Vibrations from the being you've brought with you, and start to feel this childlike wonder, this awe-inspired gazing as if you've never seen the world before, and allow this feeling to flood through you with joy. Maybe memories start coming in now. Maybe feelings of love or disappointment. or bittersweet breakups. There is no wrong feeling. We want to embody life. Feelings, real and raw ones that exist in this life. Giving ourselves space to feel. And if it's a more dark feeling that comes, remember why the darkness is coming to you. What light do you need to see from that space? What is darkness showing you that maybe you hadn't seen before? What is darkness telling you about yourself, your journey, and how even those dark and difficult times and feelings, they are not roadblocks, but they are diversions to our perfectly imperfect path. Sink deeper into your space, your co-created and co-inhabited space of love, infinite love. Sift through your memories, sift through your feelings, as if you're walking through a heavy forest, gently pushing aside branches, wandering aimlessly toward what you see as the moonlight. Allow your guide to be your ally that's next to you. Allow your guide to be this beautiful being you've shared space with today. And bring your gratitude for their power, their assistance, their love with you the whole way. You may stay here as long as you like. If you've got more realizing, remembering, sifting, working to do. Otherwise, I want you to carry this new childlike wonder, awe, and sense of discovery, realness, rawness, intuition, and love with you for the rest of the day. Harness these feelings in your heart. And know that wherever you placed your being today, is where your intuition told you, you need a little work. You need a little love, a little guidance. And when you're ready, bring your awareness back to your physical body as you breathe deeply. maybe wiggling your fingers and toes, stretching your arms overhead, away from your feet. With your eyes closed, gently rolling onto one side. And with your eyes still closed, when you're ready, gently shifting yourself up into a comfortable seat. Bring your palms together at heart center, bowing your head slightly, as we end with a prayer. We accept with open arms all of the love, abundance, health, and prosperity the universe has to offer us. We are present, we are deserving, and we are grateful. Namaste.